Hi everybody, it's Christy on Changing Christy. I just wanted to come back to you today on my week 24 post-op. I can't believe it's been 24 weeks. I'm going to be going down to see my surgeon on February 15th for my 6-month checkup. So I'm looking forward to that and seeing him again. He is in Columbus and I am more towards the Mansfield area and Ohio. I had gastric bypass surgery on August 17th, 2016. My highest weight ever recorded was in October 2014. I was 273 pounds. The day of surgery, I was 253. And today, my weight is 192.4. Last week, my weight was 193.8. So that's a loss of 1.4 pounds for the week, which I'm really happy with. It gives me a total of, a grand total of 80.6 pounds loss since I began this journey. And then since surgery, it is 60 pounds. So, my BMI currently is 34.1. I finally figured out I have to be under 30 on my BMI chart to get into the overweight class. Because I'm currently in the obese 1 class. So, I need to get to a BMI of under 30. I have 22.4 pounds to get to 170, which is my next goal. And 44.8 to get to the ultimate goal of 150, because that's the goal my surgeon set for me, is 150. So I have 44.8 more pounds to lose to get to 150. And then the other thing is kind of exciting. I only have 20 pounds to get to losing exactly 100 pounds loss. So that's exciting for me. So, I took a lot of pictures this week about some of the things that I've eaten, which I'm going to insert at the end of this clip. I did want to talk about this protein bar I did try, because I am not a fan of some protein bars. I don't like the taste of protein. I like protein shakes, but as far as bars, I can't do it. I do not like the taste of protein bars. They're just not very good tasting. So I found these. It's a Quest cereal bar. It's chocolate. I had my daughter's boyfriend pick it up for me at GNC because I couldn't find him in the grocery store or the gas station or anything like that. So he works near there. So I had him pick it up and I thought I'd try it, and it was very good. It tastes just like chocolate cereal.
Hey everybody, it's Christy. I really liked it. I just wanted to do maybe a skin flick for you guys so you can see my body. So I am going to get right to it. As you can see, here's my arms. Let me back up a little bit more so you can kind of see. You can kind of see. I don't have much. I have a little bit of a swing, but not too much. It's not like I have bat wings or anything, so it's not too bad. Do need to tone that up a little bit. I'm going to raise up my shirt so you can see my stomach. So here is my stomach. And I'll turn to the side. I do have a little bit down here. Let's see if I can pull it down just a little bit more so you kind of can see. There's a little bit right here. But my stomach has really decreased a lot. I don't think it looks too bad. Let me move the camera a little bit so you can have a better angle. Here is one of my scars. There's one. Here's one over here. He did go into my belly button. And my biggest one is right there. So
And then I'll put the camera back up and I'll show you my back.
My back doesn't look too awful bad. I think it looks pretty good too. So, and then I'll back up and I'll share you my whole body. So there's that. I'll show you my side and my back, my side. So, and that is me at 192.4. I've lost a total of 80 pounds. So I will do another one when I get to 170 and we will see if there's a difference or not. So,
okay, look what I found in the frozen soups section and the healthy section at my Kroger's. It's a garden margarita pizza. Anyway, what caught my attention, and it's just a small pizza. Let me just flip this over so you guys can see. As you can see, all the good stuff right there. But the most interesting thing is it's got 10 proteins in it, 5 sugars. It's 300 calories for half a pizza, which I thought was pretty good. These pizzas are not very big, but anyway, this is what I seen on here. Sorry, I'm making this video too long. But anyway, the crust is a smart flour pizza crust. And so it's not made with a regular flour crust. I was trying to see if it said it somewhere on the front, but it doesn't. But right there it says the ancient grains used in our smart flour has vitamins and minerals. So I'm going to try it and then I'll give my review on it. I'm not going to try it tonight, but when I do, I'll do a review on it so you guys can see. But I just want to try something that, you know, that was, I thought looked good. And then,
you know, hi guys, I'm home from lunch at work, so I'm going to try this pizza. I'm going to flip the camera around so you guys can see it. As you can see, I'm going to lift this up so you guys can see how thin it is. It's got a lot of basil on it and tomatoes and things. I'm going to stick it in the oven. It takes about 10 to 14 minutes and I will be back and I will let you know how I like it. I won't eat the whole thing, no way, but I'll let you know how I like it.
It looks pretty good.